I wanna be the queen of Egyptian hearts. I'm here.
The topic Egyptian mother-in-law is really very, very huge, and I believe I have heard a lot of say about it. Much more than it will be in this video, so I was thinking to write an ebook about it, or a book, the same as I did with the ebook and book Don't Fall in Love with Egyptian Men. Maybe write me to the comment if you would like to have it as an ebook or not. As always, 10 tips how to deal with Egyptian mother-in-law. Don't live together. Please, really, do not live together with your Egyptian mother-in-law. Why? Because she will speak to everything in the home about you, even how you dress, how you cook, or if you have problem with your husband, she will speak about the problem. If you have romantic time, she will speak about the romantic time. If your husband will bring you something, she will see it, she will want it also. There is really a lot of small details. I know that this idea to live together is good, but it's not simply working. On the other hand, if you are living separately, you appreciate each other much more and you have much better relationship together. But I believe this is not only for Egypt, this is for any other country. Simply, it's a normal. It's even different generation, so it will not work together very well. You have to treat her like a queen, really. You have to treat your Egyptian mother-in-law as a queen. This is Egyptian rule, which I don't know if it's good or bad. I will not judge this one, but you have to know it. Example now on Egyptian, when the mother-in-law coming visit to your home, so they are really like afraid, everything has to be clean, everything must be perfect, food must be perfect. So they are like afraid from her visit. And whatever your mom-in-law tell you, you must simply agree on. You cannot disagree with her. Or you must buy her gifts, or you must treat her and love her much more than your mom, and so on. Simply imagine how you will treat a queen, so this way treat the Egyptian mother-in-law. Never speak badly about her son. This is a very important point, really. Because she will never go against her son, really. In Egypt, it doesn't work like this. Whatever her son do bad to you, okay? Even if it's the worst thing ever, do not complain to your mother-in-law. She will always see that you are guilty and she'll never go against her son. Simply, her son is the king of this world, king of the universe, and you will be always the guilty one. So take care of this point. She will not help you. Even whatever she can tell you, she'll never help you, really. If you want to complain to someone, complain to your family or to your friends, if you don't have family here in Egypt, right? But really, do not do it with your Egyptian mother-in-law. You must bring your son. Another Egyptian rule, which we already discussed, but it's a fact. You don't have son, so your Egyptian mother-in-law will still push on you and tell you you have to bring another children, you must bring the son and take care. Maybe if you, for example, say I don't want to bring children anymore, okay, so maybe she will push on her son to even marry another woman. This is really happening here, and now I know many Egyptians maybe will be angry at me, but I really don't care. This is the fact and I will not lie. I saw it many times in my life here with many people around me, really many. This is happening. It's even for me a not good thing, a horrible thing even, but this is Egypt. Simply, if you want to be in good relationship, even in this point, you must bring a son. If your Egyptian mother-in-law doesn't really like you and she's telling you impolite words and she's insulting you and gossip on you, whatever, you always must stay polite to her. You cannot rebuke her, okay? So you cannot scream at her, you cannot be impolite to her, you cannot tell her rude words, nothing like this. You must always stay in the good manner and listen to what she tells about you or tells you directly, doesn't matter. But you must stay polite. And if it's hurting you so much, So I will give you advice. Whatever she tell you after you leave her house or leave her company, simply throw the words behind you like it never happened, you never listened, and act really like nothing happened. Because if you don't do this, then you will be very sad from it, you will cry, she can particularly destroy your life, destroy your mood, whatever, and you will be the one who will suffer and you will be the one who will be sad from it. So remember, whatever she tells really doesn't matter. She doesn't live with you and she doesn't live your life, so don't pay attention to it. You must visit her once a week. This is a rule here that the parents are going to be visit once a week. And even you have to invite her to your home from time to time. Even she can sleep in your house, it's like normal. But to have like a good connection, this is working here very well. If she tells you the word or the sentence, you are exactly like her daughter. So take care, this sentence always are bringing a lot of problems, a lot. Really never trust a cheap and sweet or sweet words. Okay, because probably they are fake and not so honest, not from the heart. Your Egyptian mother-in-law, she will be jealous on you, always. This is the fact. Simply, you stole her son. You stole the king of the universe, right? So she will be jealous on you. Whatever, even if you have good relation together, from time to time the jealousy can appear, not for a long time maybe, maybe for a long time or not. It depends on the Egyptian mother-in-law. But I'm telling you, you don't be jealous of her of this point. It's a normal, and maybe if you have a son, so you will understand one day the same way. Please accept it and don't be sad from it or don't make a problem. If your Egyptian mother-in-law do something bad to you or something you do not like, so never go complain to your husband. Please don't do it. It will bring you a lot of problems in the home, in the husband, with the husband itself, okay? And he will never go against his family and especially against his mother. He will never do it. His mom is on the first place. This is in our religion, in Islam, in the first place. So he love her the most. He love her more than you. But this is even a normal thing, I believe. Do not complain to your husband. As I told before, complain to any other person in this earth, but don't do it with your husband. And probably you will spend all the vacation together. Whatever vacation it will be, if it's Ramadan or Eid, or you go in the summer to the sea, swim, you will spend it always with the family of your husband. Really, this is working even for Egyptian women, that they are spending the time with the family of the husband much more than with her own family in these important events. So prepare on it. And if you don't have a good relationship with the Egyptian mother-in-law, this can be kind of hard time for you. But as I told, if you don't pay attention to it and whatever she tells you, you simply agree on it, so you will not have a problem. But the point is, you have to respect her and she should respect you. But if she doesn't respect you, at least you respect her, because you are better than her. This is a good point. You always treat like you are the better person than the one who is, for example, hurting you. Okay, and maybe I have for you a last tip, like an 11. Here is also a tradition that the son is bringing to the mom, like gifts. Can be really expensive gifts, can be money or whatever the mom from the son wants, he should give her. So if you see that your husband is spending a lot on his mom or on his family, actually on his old family, because you are now his family new, so it's really normal here, and please don't be angry from it. Maybe you can feel like they are stealing money from you, but this is here how it's working. So but your husband of course should be able to comfort you whatever you wish and need. Okay, so there must be some balance. But if he want to give the gift to her mom or a money, whatever, let him do it. It's fine.